We want to determine the derivative of f of x equals 2x times the quantity 7x squared minus 2 raised to the fourth power. We can't distribute this 2x because this is raised to the fourth power. So we need to recognize that we have a product of two functions, so we'll have to apply the product rule, but also when differentiating the second function, we'll have to apply the chain rule. So to apply the product rule, let's let the first function equal 2x, we'll call it f, and we'll let the second function equal this quantity to the fourth, and we'll call this g. So before we actually find any derivatives, let's write out the product rule. So f prime of x is going to be equal to the first function, which is 2x, times the derivative of the second function, which is the quantity 7x squared minus 2 raised to the fourth, plus the second function, 7x squared minus 2 to the fourth, times the derivative of the first function. So now let's focus on determining this first derivative here. This is a composite function, so we'll let u equal the inner function. So we'll let 7x squared minus 2 equal u, which means this entire function becomes u to the fourth. So to differentiate u to the fourth, we'll differentiate this with respect to u and then multiply it by u prime, applying the extended power rule given here below. And then, of course, the derivative of 2x is just 2. So let's write out the next step. We're going to have 2x times the derivative of u to the fourth. Well, that'll be 4u to the third. But instead of writing u to the third, remember u is equal to 7x squared minus 2, times u prime. And u prime is a derivative of 7x squared minus 2, which would be 14x. Plus 7x squared minus 2 to the fourth times 2. Now that we have our derivative, we want to try to simplify this. So in this first product, we can multiply 2x, 4, and 14x. That's going to be 112x squared times the quantity 7x squared minus 2 to the third plus the second product is just 2 times the quantity 7x squared minus 2 to the fourth power. Now to factor this sum, we need to identify the greatest common factor. And the greatest common factor of these two products would be 2 and then 3 factors of 7x squared minus 2. So we want to factor this out of both of these products. So looking at this first product, if we factor a 2 out of 112x squared, we'd have 56x squared. And notice that we're factoring all three factors of 7x squared minus 2 out, so we're just left with 56x squared. And then on the second product, we're factoring out the 2 and only 3 factors of 7x squared minus 2, so we're left with 1 factor of 7x squared minus 2. And the last step is to combine like terms. Notice how here we have 2x squared terms. So our final derivative is going to be 2 times the quantity 7x squared minus 2 to the third times, here we'll have 63x squared minus 2. And this would be the factored form of our derivative. So looking back at what we did, notice how once we apply the product rule and the chain rule to determine this derivative here, from this step on, it was all algebra. We'll take a look at two more examples that require both the product rule and the chain rule in the next two videos. I hope this example was helpful.